What we need today more than anything else is to invest in beauty. Because beauty is harmony which comes from chaos. But we invest in chaos. And why we invest in chaos? Because chaos is much more profitable than peace. Nothing is geared for beauty, from architecture to art to anything. Everything is destroyed. And music as well. I don't think music is beautiful today. Music is just a way to advertise other things, because music is very powerful as force. And then through music, we can advertise anything we want. That's why people, and actually they are a certain age today, they're still doing the same and they look ridiculous. Music is a different thing. It's one of the most important things that have been distorted, like many other things. You see, everything we talk about peace is distorted, we talk about love is distorted, we talk about music is distorted. So we have to think, maybe at night when we are alone, about some music. What is love? The universe is music. My teacher is nature itself. My teacher is music.
I like to tell a story of a hummingbird. I don't know how many of you have heard me tell about the hummingbird, but I like to tell about the story of a hummingbird because quite often we feel overwhelmed. So this story of a hummingbird, which I learned from Japan, is the story of a forest that caught fire. And it was a huge fire, and it was raging. And all the animals came out of the forest and stood by the edge of the forest, and they were watching the fire. They were very overwhelmed, they were powerless. They felt like there was nothing they could do because the problem was too much for them. Except this little hummingbird. The hummingbird said, "I'm going to do something about the fire." So it flew to the nearest stream, took a drop of water, back and put it on the fire, then back again, brought another drop of water and put it on the fire, and it kept going as fast as it could, every time bringing a drop of water and putting it on the fire. In the meantime, all these animals are discouraging it and are persuading it not to bother because it is too little. You have a beak, it's too little, you are bringing very little water, and some of the animals that are talking like that are the elephants with the big trunk, which could bring much more water, but the hummingbird just kept doing what it knew best without wasting any time. And to stop them when they said, "What do you think you are doing?" And the hummingbird said, "I'm doing the best I can." Whatever.
Dang.